Welcome back. Our tester is set up for a Cat5e test. Now it's time to run that test. But before we do that, we'll want to set a reference. To do that, very easy. Permanent link adapter on the main unit, connected into the channel adapter on the remote unit. Amanda, please tap Tools and set reference and test. This is something you're going to want to do each day. The manual does say at least 30 days, but part of this process is also a self-test. So it's a good idea to do this each day. And as you can see, it's very quick. Okay, go ahead and tap done. Now we're going to connect the tester into our magical box here and run a test. So I'm going to get you to take that off there. I'll grab that for you. And you connect that one in there. And this is just my fun demo box. It has a number of faults in there. Hopefully this link is going to pass. Now you may have heard the instruments chirp. Whenever they connect to each other, you'll hear that chirp. And that's really useful for the individual at the other end because they'll know that they're actually connected into the correct outlet. So also noting in the top left-hand corner here, next to the battery gauge, you're also going to see two little testers with green arrows pointing at each other. So when they're connected, that indicates that they are connected and they're talking to each other. Okay, Amanda, go ahead and press the home key for me and tap test. And for a Cat5e test, it's around about 8 to 9 seconds. Cat6, Cat6a is around about 10 seconds. So it's a pretty quick test to do on this tester, certainly much faster than the DTX on Cat6a. So this tester passed. We see the pass in the top right-hand corner. The first thing that we see on there is wire map. Amanda, go ahead and tap performance for me. Now we see what's very familiar to DTX owners is all the various parameters required for Cat5e. Everything passes here, so we're good. Go ahead and hit save. And because we pre-configured all the cable IDs, we don't have to tap in the cable IDs. We can just go save. And we can move on to our next test. Let's change the test out here. I'm going to swap this across to another link. And again, I hear the chirp, so I know that they're actually connected. Okay, Amanda, go ahead and tap test again for me. So again, it's running the insertion loss, the near end crosstalk, the return loss, all the measurements that are required by both the standards and your cabling warranty, cabling vendor for their warranty application. Uh-oh, it failed. Now, what you're going to do at this stage is go ahead and tap diagnostics for me, Amanda. What you've got now is the next generation of automated diagnostics fault info. This tester is smart enough that it can actually locate RJ45 connections in the link. So if you had a consolidation point, you'd actually see three connectors on the screen here. What the tester is telling us is the connection at the far end is bad and it needs fixing. Further information is available by tapping the box, if you'd like to go ahead and tap the box. And we give you a little bit more information, but the bottom line is we need to go to the far end and sort out that termination. Okay, back to go back. Let's save that result. Now we have two options. We have fix later or test again. So if you're in the mood for fixing that issue now, you go ahead and fix it and do test again and hopefully get a pass and save the result. Maybe you're just testing and testing and testing, in which case you're going to fix it later. So go ahead and tap fix later. That brings up our cable ID selection here. You'll notice that 01A is missing because we've already tested that. It's jumped to 01B. Let's go ahead and hit save. And you are good to go. One more thing that's kind of cute about this tester. Go ahead and press the home key for me, Amanda. At any one stage, you can go to the home screen and see how you're progressing with the job. So on here, you can actually see that we have a one tick, green tick, and a one X. That tells us we have one passing, one failing. You're also going to see a percentage on here. That's going to track how well you're doing with your job. So because we pre-configured all the cable IDs, if you only get halfway through your cable IDs, then you're only going to see 50% here. It really reduces the possibility of missing links that you're supposed to test. Okay, so that's testing with the DSX-5000. On the next video, I'm going to show you how to download those results to your PC and print them out and how to present them to your customer.